Chapter 1, the leaf, modification of leaves. Now, what do you mean by modification? Modification means to modify, to change, a structural change. So, modification means a structural change required to perform a specialized function, such as support, storage of food, defense, etc. So, plant, what they do? They modify themselves according to the environment they are living in. Now, why they do so? They do it for to get support, to store food, and to get defense from their enemies. For each of these functions, they have been modified into different forms. And they are modified, these leaves, they are modified into different forms, like tendrils, and they modify themselves into spines and then into scale leaves. Let us study one by one. What are they? The first one is leaves. What they do? They modify themselves into a thin thread-like structure called tendril. Now, they coil around a support in order to give support to the weaker stems. Examples are wild pea and glory lily. Now, some leaf, they modify themselves into spines. Spines means pointed structures. Now, these when leaves of some desert plants become modified into pointed spines, they are called leaf spines. Now, the spines, they act as a defensive structures. How? Because they perform defensive role as they keep away grazing animals. They keep away from enemies, their enemies. So they also reduce water loss due to transpiration. Transpiration, you know, is the process in which water, it changes into water vapor in the air from leaves, from the surface of the leaves. Then the example of leaf spines are spines in cactus. You must have seen cactus plant. So the spines in the cactus, they are actually the modification of leaf. Then comes scale leaves. Now in some plants, leaves, they get modified as scale leaves. And why? Because they help to protect the bud. Now these leaves, they also store food. They may be dry as in garlic or fleshy as in onion. Modification of leaves in insectivorous plants. Now insectivorous plants are the plants that are carnivorous in nature. Carnivorous animals, you know, they eat flesh of other animals. The same way insectivorous plants, they eat flesh of other insects. And why they do so? Because they require nitrogen for their development. And why they need nitrogen? Because they usually occur in damp heaths, bogs, swamps, and muddy or sandy shores where there is abundant water but lack nitrogenous materials due to unfavorable soil conditions. So, in such plants, the leaves are modified to catch and digest insects. They are also known as carnivorous plants. Now, let us study some examples of leaf modifications in these plants. Now, the first one is pitcher plant. Now, pitcher, you know, what the leaf, it is shaped like a pitcher. Now, the lamina of the leaf, it gets modified into a pitcher. And the tip of the lamina, the leaf apex, the top part of the leaf, it changes into the a lid which can open or close the mouth of the pitcher. Now there are hairs inside the pitcher which are directed downwards. When an insect falls in the pitcher, the lid closes. This lid closes, and the trapped insect gets entangled in the hair of the pitcher and hence cannot come out. After some time, the insect dies in the pitcher and the walls of the pitcher secrete digestive juices which digest the proteins present in the body of the insect to form simpler nitrogen compounds. So these simpler nitrogen compounds are absorbed by the walls of the pitcher and used by the whole pitcher plant. Then comes bladderwort, Utricularia. Now this is a Utricularia plant, and this is a flower, and these are bladders. Now this is a single bladder, and there is a trapdoor here. This is a trapdoor. And here when the minute organisms, when they enter here in the trapdoor, they cannot come out and they get trapped here inside the bladder. And this is how they feed on organism. Venus flytrap. Now you can see this. This is a leaf. This is a modified leaf. And here you can see this is the midrib, and it acts as a hinge of the door. You know, hinge. It helps in opening and closing of the door. The same way this midrib, it helps in the opening and closing of the leaf blade. Now these are hairs, what are these? Leaf hairs, long leaf hairs. And what it does, when any insect, it touches the leaf here, then the edges of the leaf, it suddenly interlock. It gets closed and prevent the escape of insect. And the plant then secrete digestive juices and enzymes to digest the insect. Vegetative propagation. Now in vegetative propagation, new plants are produced from the parts of old plants like stems, roots or leaves. Generally, plants that develop from the seeds, but in vegetative propagation, new plants, they also grow from stems, roots or leaves. Now it usually involves the growth and development of one or more buds on the old part of the plant to produce a new plant. Now you can see here, new plants, they can also develop from the old plant. Now see potato is a is an underground stem. Now here you can see these are the eyes of potato. These are actually buds. Now the new plants, they grow out from the potato through these eye. These are buds. Then this is ginger. And ginger, when a part of ginger is grown in the ground, then the ginger plant, it grows out from the ginger, apart from the ginger. Now this is rose, and they can grow from the stem cutting. Vegetative propagation by leaves. That means how new plants, they grow out from leaves. Now some plants produce buds on their leaves, like bryophyllum. What they do, they grow buds on their leaves. Then the margin of leaves bear buds. You can see here, this is a bryophyllum leaf, and this is the margin of the leaf, and these are notches, and the buds, they produce here at the notches. Then these buds are in the dormant state. Dormant state means they are in inactive state when it is attached with the plant. When it is attached to the plant, they are in dormant stage. And when provided with suitable conditions like food, moisture, warmth, etc., these grow to form new plants. And one more thing, when they come in contact with the soil, when they get a moist soil, then they start growing into a new plant. This is a bryophyllum leaf, and these are buds. And when they get favorable conditions, they grow out and form new plant.